And if you don't do it properly on that particular day, so definitely you will feel yourself you are not that a particular period successfully. So this is way, please keep it in mind. So primary teachers, who are teaching Hindi madam to class 1 and 2? Okay. So you can tell me now.
Yes, after a small spell of rain in the morning, now the weather is good. Now, so I welcome everybody for this pleasant morning assembly. Now, today I have the privilege of welcoming the members of the inspection team in our primary assembly here. Three eminent experts are here with us today to watch our activities throughout the day. From morning up to 2:40 in the evening, they will watch all the activities of the students and the teachers.
In the end of this year, so all the farmers are requested to plant the best vegetable and display on the inspection day. It will be judged by our inspection team members. I will plant huge carrots and achieve the award. I will plant the tall rams and achieve the award. All the farmers started planting their vegetables. They planted carrots, drumsticks, tomatoes and pumpkins. I am sure I will win in this competition. Look at the size of my pumpkin. Don't be so confident. My carrot shines like gold. Oh, I will win. Look at my drumstick. They are very tall. The fourth farmer came with a basket full of regular sized tomatoes. The other farmers could not control their laugh. Dear ladies and gentlemen, today is our panel inspection. So all the farmers are requested to exhibit their vegetable for the judgment. It will be judged by our inspection team members. We all know who is not winning the competition this time. Hello, Aditya Verma. Don't forget to get your participation certificate before you leave. Everybody laughed, but he did not respond to the comments. Judges started to judge the exhibit. Oh, look at the size of the pumpkin. How did you grow it, sir?
The secret to its growth is the use of pesticide. I sprayed a good amount of pesticide to kill all the worms. Then I removed chunks of soil to build a soil cement platform, on which I placed my pumpkin so that it could continue in a clean base. See the beautiful shiny carrots. How did you grow it, sir? See, my gigantic shiny carrots are the result of using fungicides, insecticides and chemical fertilizer, which prevents the growth of caterpillars and earthworms. I also removed all the other plants that grew around the carrot patch to make a place for those plants to grow without any competition. See the long drumstick. How did you grow it, sir?
Sir, I use special chemical to kill the worms. I water the plants regularly and took care of all my drumsticks.
Sir, how did you manage to grow such tasty tomatoes? I began by tending to the soil using what I call the three-step magic plan. First, I dug a shallow pit, planted the tomato seeds and watered them. This shallow pit held the water within it, so the seeds had adequate water and there was no wastage of soil because the water wouldn't run. Then I planted lots of other plants around the tomato patch. Plants that would not compete with the tomato plant for the same nutrition. These plants made sure that the soil was not blown away by the wind. At lastly, I added biodegradable waste small vegetable peas and fruit pulp to the soil to act as organic fertilizer and improve the quality of soil. This is what made the tomatoes tasty.
I just were impressed by the farmer's three-step magic plan. It was simple yet effective. After a round of discussion, they announced the winner of the annual vegetable competition. I am proud to declare Farmer 4 as the winner of this year's contest. Moreover, I also request all others to hereby follow his three-step magic plan by growing fruits and vegetables. So, his tomatoes were so small and dull looking.
And what's so special about this so-called magic plan?
His tomatoes may be small, but they taste just of all. I tasted today. They are fresh and free from any chemicals too. His magic plan is not about magic, but about being environmentally conscious while growing nuts. His method enriched the soil, did not waste the water, did not kill the earthworms.
What use are earthworms? They are just pests.
On the contrary, earthworms are extremely useful for your plants. They loosen up the soil, which helps increase the amount of air and water which gets into it. They also break down organic waste like leaves and vegetable peels into a form that the plants can use.
Farmer was declared the winner. They went to congratulate him.
Congratulations, your win was well deserved. Yes, it was, and we also learned how we can grow vegetables and fruits without causing the environment. We want apologies for not making one earlier. Thank you, friends. I am happy that you have learned that it was not the appearance of the vegetable but how it grew that matter.
Could you help us with our farm vegetable? It would be much better followed your method.
Of course, I would love to help you.
The moral of the story is, we should not use chemicals while growing plants. Thank you.
Very good. My respected Madam Bindu, Sri Ravi Mahadeva, Mr. in charge of this Vidyalaya, all my dear teachers and dear students. Actually, I was not supposed to come here. I took it voluntarily. Why? There is a very strong reason behind that. I was a primary teacher and joined Kendra Vidyalaya Sangathan as a primary teacher in 1993. Even though this was for a very small span of time, 3 months, I enjoyed my teaching life the maximum when I was a primary teacher. So that's why wherever I get chance to interact with primary teachers and primary students, I was very happy. What I noticed here in this morning assembly that made me actually more cheerful and more enthusiastic about this Vidyalaya. We are hearing a lot about Chennai schools, but Dgqa has got a very special
position of panel inspection. Sir, on behalf of my staff members, assure you that we will implement all the suggestions given by you word for word in our Vidyalaya to our best. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much to all.
Oh,